What's happening, guys? It is Sunday, April 4th, Easter Sunday for many people, unless you're like me, who's Eastern Orthodox. We don't celebrate for another month, but we are en route to Wrigley Field. We are going to see Pirates Cubs today. The great return to Wrigley this weekend. They've already had two games. This will be my first, and yeah, this is exciting, so let's do this.
We are heading down School Street, and I'm going to be avoiding Clark just because of all the people. So I'm going straight to Sheffield Avenue, which is okay because I got to enter through that gate anyway. So it's a really nice day, not a cloud in the sky. Hopefully the game is as good as the weather. So I guess a little bit about today's game. Zach Davies going for the Cubs. First start as a Cub. Played many years with the Milwaukee Brewers, so he's very familiar with Wrigley Field and a lot of his teammates. He's kind of a Kyle Hendricks light. He uses a lot of change-ups and sinkers, doesn't throw very hard. He's no Yu Darvish, that's for sure, but, you know, he's had a pretty decent career, so, you know, hopefully he could pitch well enough today. And then for the Pirates, I believe they have Mitch Keller going today. And he's been with the Pirates a few years. Cubs have seen him a few times, so not a huge matchup, but, you know, we'll see how it goes. So we're right at Clark and School in Adeline. The ballpark's that way. I am a little early, so I might even take a bigger detour than I thought, just to kill a little time, because they want certain people entering at certain times, depending on what ticket you have, just to reduce the flow of traffic. So a few things to note about this return to Wrigley. This will be the first time I've attended a game where Gary Pressey is not playing the organ. Also, you can see the netting has been extended. It's been pretty well advertised that they were going to be extending the nets in MLB stadiums for fan safety. And there's a good look at the recently renovated booth. There's the marquee logo up there. As you can also see out in the bleachers, the first few rows are tapered off with advertising, probably just a way to keep more distancing and maybe create the appropriate space needed for the amount of fans. But, you know, everything else looks great and good, and back the old ballpark. They are playing the final countdown, my favorite song, Life Complete.
Number 40, Wilson Contreras! Heading third, the first baseman, number 44, Anthony Rizzo. Batting in the cleanup spot, the third baseman, number 17, Chris Bryant. Batting fifth and playing left field, number 24, Chuck Peterson. Hitting sixth and playing shortstop, number 9, Javier Baez. Batting seventh and playing right field, number 22, Jason Hayward. Hitting eighth and playing second base, number 4, Eric Sogard. Batting ninth, the starting pitcher for the Cubs today, right-hander number 27, Zach Davies.
You're my baby.
directly after the ball game.
Bottom of the eighth, it's getting late, 4-3 game, pretty tight. They just got a big double play ball. Rex Brothers induced a double play. So three more defensive outs to get, a few more insurance runs would be pretty nice.
He's like, oh yeah. Peer pressure.
Ball game, 4-3, Cubs win. It was a tight one. The offense wasn't particularly great, but they pulled it out. Craig Kimbrel looks great today again. He struck out two more guys. Zach Davies outside his last inning looks fantastic. Cubs will take this series 2-3. It was awesome being back here. This was just an emotional time. Being able to be in this ballpark again, a place I love so much, this just meant the world to me. All right, guys, peace out.